Hello students, how are you? Myself Vinita Mondol, assistant professor in physics at KKM College Jamui. Due to worldwide pandemic, we have to take classes through YouTube videos. I hope you all follow these videos and go through all these topics. And let me know if there are any queries, okay? In the last two lectures, I have taught you Stack effect and Peltier effects. Thermoelectric effect consists of three effects I have already mentioned. Okay, one is Seebeck effect, another is Peltier effect, and last one is Thomson effect. Seebeck effect is such that if we take a thermocouple made up of two dissimilar metals, and if the junctions of two metals are kept at different temperatures, then EMF is produced and current flows in the circuit. Okay, this is Seebeck effect. Peltier effect is reverse of Seebeck effect. I have told you in the second lecture. If we take a thermocouple of two dissimilar metals and an electric current is sent in the circuit by a battery, then heat is absorbed at one junction and liberated at the other junction. Therefore, a temperature difference is created. Okay. So, this is Peltier effect. I have completed Seebeck effect and Peltier effect. Today, I will discuss about the last effect, which is called Thomson effect. Here, if we take a material where and create a temperature gradient along the wire, then EMF is produced in the wire. This phenomenon is called Thomson effect. Like Peltier effect, this Thomson effect is also reversible, because if the sign of the temperature gradient is reversed, the direction of the EMF also reverses. If we take two points in the wire whose temperatures are at T Kelvin and T plus dT Kelvin, then the potential difference between the two points will be sigma into dT, where sigma is called the Thomson coefficient. The Thomson coefficient is the potential difference for unit temperature difference between two points. The unit of sigma is volt per degree. Okay. The coefficient sigma may be positive or negative. It is positive when a point at higher temperature is at higher potential than a point at lower temperature inside the conductor, and sigma will be negative in opposite case, that is when a point at higher temperature is at lower potential than a point at lower temperature. Okay. If a current I ampere flows in the wire in the direction of the positive temperature gradient for T second, and if sigma is positive, then energy I into T into sigma into dT joule is absorbed. And if the current flows in the direction of negative temperature gradient, the same amount of heat will be evolved. If sigma is negative, then the situation will be reverse. Okay. So therefore, I have defined the Thomson coefficient sigma. And these two situations, that is positive sigma and negative sigma case, is illustrated graphically in the figure 13.5. Okay. So this is Thomson effect. So in the previous two lectures, I have discussed about Seebeck effect and Peltier effect. Today I have discussed the Thomson effect. These three effects are combinedly known as thermoelectric effects. Okay. So I have completed the thermoelectric effect. Okay, students, go through it and let me know if there are any queries. Okay. Okay, continue reading. Okay. Thanks. Bye.